Staying well out of that is also tough. That being said,
speaking of your carpool, let's talk about PkChris.
Chris is really, really good. He's been kind of dominating Long Island as of late. He's been getting pretty much first or second at most of the Aeons, except for yesterday to Sohn. This matchup I love a lot. It is the one matchup where I think Fox can't really get out of it. Fox has to play really patiently. He has to wait a lot before he presses a button. Same thing with Ness. I think we're going to see a war of who is waiting to press their big buttons first. When Light is one of the best players at mixing up recoveries, and I'd say that's the biggest thorn in Fox's side in this matchup. So I want to see how Light can handle recovering against Chris, because Chris has been leveling up really hard.
Yeah, for sure. I was watching Chris a little bit earlier versus DM, and I was talking to him a little bit after, and I told him something that he kind of like kept in the back of his head. I feel like a lot of the times with Chris's gameplay and a lot of the players that are younger, they always go for the clip and sometimes put themselves in disadvantage. Like, just go for the confirm, especially on a character like Ness, where you have confirms left and right off of every move, really.
It's true.
It's just do something simple, and especially versus Light, don't get the clip on Light. It's much more cooler to get the win on Light not let your lead up.
And Light, also a player that if he gets clipped, is also still likely to win the set as
well.
Yeah, true. Like, from what we've seen, at least in his prior playing. Like, I remember during the back when Syrup was first on his come up, he clipped the hell out of Light on Elite Smash, and Light still won the game.
Yep, very true.
Chris's execution is really, really good, and so is Light's. So it's going to be really interesting to see how both of these characters with blessed frame data kind of shape up against each other.
Very, very true. But once again, Light coming down with that signature aggression. I love the way this guy plays. I mean, a fan favorite for a reason.
For real.
One of the only Foxes to do it, I think, aside from like a player like ZD and MDBA. Mm-hmm. And even then, he doesn't travel as much as possible. But I think a lot of these like landing nairs from Light are insane. And also that side magnet back air was pretty nice from PkChris as well.
I can't believe he slipped right by him for that too. It seems like Chris is having a lot of difficulty getting off of the ledge against Light. Paris is just not biting for anything right there.
No, dude.
One thing, if you guys are looking into any matchup against Fox, do not drop shield and try to do something out of shield against Fox Bear. It is safe. Do not do it. I see so many players drop shield. Don't do it. Don't try to roll in either. It'll still hit you somehow.
Very, very true.
As we've seen from Zomba versus Light.
That's very, very true. But yeah, some of these like nairs leading into Imagination there, I feel like Light is just the pioneer of this character. He's so creative with his routes. And you know certain times when like falling nair up smash, you know it's going to hit. But here comes Light, though. Down throw is going to be the option here. Going to opt to just kind of ride high in the sky. I love the way he takes it patient as well. But of course, the back air, not going to be able to take it quite yet. Light at 120 goes for the shine spike. Do it again. It doesn't even matter. That's untechable. But regardless, Light is going to take that game home.
That really early jump from Chris kind of sealed his fate. It's tough because Light could have also achieved the same thing by going off with like a fast fall in there or something like that to clip the first jump. But the fact that Chris burned his jump so far out made it, you know, the only way that Chris was able to recover was low diagonal. Light with the drop off shine just doing it perfectly while Chris exhausted all those resources. Went off stage because either way, if Ness does collide with something physical as he's on his way up, he slows his momentum completely and he's just dead. I think.
Where do you think we're going?
Mm-hmm. I think Chris, if he's smart, he bans. Or Light, if he's smart, he's going to ban like.
Oh, that's right. It's on stream.
FT and Smash Bros. I think those are the right bands to do against Fox, honestly, or against Ness. Ness's best stages happen to be the flat ones. Fox likes platforms a lot, so he's definitely going to go here. If you notice, Light is in the game today. Like, he's head bobbing. If he's messing up Punish, he's very emotive. I don't know.
Like, he's very irritated that he lost doubles. He's definitely, like...
It's an ego bruiser, for sure.
It definitely is an ego bruiser to lose to two guys that are, you know, significantly not as good as you. I mean... I love Beast and Tilde a lot, but, you know, Light is a kind of entity of his own at this point.
I agree.
Kalos, interesting. You know what? I actually really like this.
This is actually one of Light's favorite stages.
Really? Oh, yeah. I mean, that makes sense. Nair up smash? Jeez, that's going to KO at like 80 on this like stage at all.
But Chris picked it, so I'm very concerned to see how this is going to go. I was going to say before, Light is a player that wears his heart on his sleeve most of the time. You know, he's very emotive while he plays. I guess it is now, but he's very emotional. He is very in tune to the game. You know, you can even see it in the way he just plays. He is locked in. He's super confident, and he wants to make sure his execution is perfect. And you know, he'll ride his own momentum really, really well. I feel like Chris is also a similar player in that metric too. These two are actually very alike personality-wise. I can feel like Light's a little more laid back, but
for sure.
Both these guys are really good. Still, Chris is spending most of his time at the edge of the stage. He might have to buy a timeshare here because he's getting just back into oblivion right now.
That's very true. gonna
Shouts to everyone in the chat who doesn't know what a timeshare is.
Oh god, we're old, Fang. We're old. Up air is gonna connect though, and this is one of the reasons why I feel like we went to this stage. FD and Smashville were banned. This is the flattest stage you're gonna get. Obviously not my favorite stage in, you know, the world. I do think this is a very polarizing stage. Mm-hmm. But doesn't even seem to matter though for Light gonna be able to pick it right back up with the up air. Going for the rapid job though, nice. Let's see how Chris can respond. And once again, just hanging out on the ledge as much as possible.
Yeah.
Double up air from Light. Then I thought he was actually going to try to go for a reverse forward smash there and just get the hard read on the flat.
Yeah, for real. I think another thing also is that Light has definitely caught up to Chris's tempo a lot. His reactions are looking nigh perfect right now. Chris is also opting for a lot of very aggressive options where Light is not committing first, you know? I feel like he needs to wait for Light to jump or something like that firsthand. He's been swinging first, and Light has been dissecting him completely every single time he swings.
Absolutely. So back into the neutral here, Chris. Down a very fair share amount of damage at this point. 53 on Light is nothing to scoff at. Gonna offer the back throw a little bit early. Honestly, gotta get some cheese off of it. So I'm gonna go for a couple down tilts. Gonna be able to find the PK fire.
Ooh, wow.
Oh, baited out the up air and still
good.
Just got the grab.
He
was able to confirm.
I was
shook just as much as shook as we are. Jeez.
Light, Fox is light, but I feel like that was some yucky DR. No, this is huge for Chris. No! He gives complete stage control to Light because he was expecting an immediate side B. But given the trajectory he got hit, Light could have only gone to ledge there. That was a huge punt. Like, every time you get Fox off stage, that is your go time. That's when it's game time for Ness in this matchup.
For sure, but now Light going to be able to take Chris coast to coast at this point. Yeah, he's looking for that back air on the on the plat too. Plat is great, great movement for him. Okay, I'm going to be able to find the fair.
I
love the little wave dash back into the center of the stage there by Chris here.
Ooh,
okay, falling up air back throw. You were
that
saying this before,
crazy.
Fang. This is go time, but unfortunately, he's going to opt for the more passive option. What do you think about that F smash?
That was a misinput, I think.
Okay.
I don't think he wanted to. Excellent, though. Chris has been using these reverse magnets so well. Light is knocked up in the air, has no jump, but Paris falling there into up smash. I've seen it claim so many Ness players before. I think Chris played a lot better that second game. I think he missed very, very critical punishment opportunities right there. It's just a testament to how consistent Light is. Like, I don't think this is a winning matchup for Fox. I don't even think it's even. Any Fox player who would disagree with me, you're off that boof. But I do think that Paris is very consistent. He's able to play these matchups really well. And his disadvantage is so good. Like, we praise him for his aggression, but I've never seen a Fox player recover to stage so many times consistently.
Yeah.
He just doesn't die. He's like a cockroach.
That key moment, like, right there where you kind of just, like, where he let Light come back, but then he realized that the up air didn't hit. Cool, you're still in hit stun, but let me just get behind you real quick and back throw you. But once again, a really good set from Light and what we saw from Mars. Yeah, that's brutal. That
he
one
tried
hurts.
To catch the landing with dash attack. That only works if Fox lands a little bit out of range. Light was clearly fading in. I think Chris is better off just shielding there. Because if Fox is landing, he can plow
good
right
ball.
Through everything Ness does. If you try up air, Nair will beat it. If you do fast fall Nair, everything just gets beaten. It's tough. Still, though, not the end of Chris. It's unfortunate that this late in the bracket it is only best of three, but, you know, we're on a time crunch.
We are on
I'm sure
time
we got
crunch.